Thank you. Hello, my talk today is mainly about attacks against wound reduced version of Prince Leo and I submitted to the Prince Challenge. So I will begin by a short introduction about Prince and the Prince Challenge. Then I will present the meet in the middle attacks we found against 6, 8, and 10 rounds of Prince. Then I will describe a differential SAT-based attack against 6 rounds of Prince. And finally, I will show a 4-round distinguisher against 4-round distinguisher against Prince Core based on cycles. So let's begin by the introduction. Prince is a 64-bit block cipher published at AsiaCrypt 3 years ago. It is based on the FX construction, but where the first and the last keys are linearly related. The underlying block cipher is called Prince Core, and it's a 12-round substitution permutation network such that the decryption process with the key K is equal to the encryption process with the key K plus alpha, where alpha is a constant given in the specification of Prince. So the Prince Challenge was organized by the designers of Prince, and it's about practical attacks against wound-reduced versions of Prince. Here, practical means that the data complexity, the amount of data available is limited to either to the 20 chosen plain text or to the 30 non-plain text. So there are 10 challenges which differ by the number of rounds to be attacked. And three winners were identified at the end of the first round of the challenge. As you can see for the easy half of the challenges. So Leo and I are responsible for almost all of those attacks. And we would like to thank people behind the Prince Challenge for the chocolates and beers they sent us as a reward. They were very tasty and there were enough to share with our team, so thank you. There were also money prizes for attacks against 8, 10, and 12 rounds for truly practical attacks, meaning a time complexity below 2 to the 64 and a memory below 2 to the 45 bytes. Okay. So the first kind of attack we applied against round-reduced versions of Prince was meet-in-the-middle attack. And more precisely, the kind of attack Demircian Celsius used against the AES. This kind of attack is nowadays well understood, and it relies on two subcomponents. First, a truncated difference which is propagated in both ways with probability 1, and a basic meet-in-the-middle attack. So there are many variants of the attack according to how the cipher is splitted, which difference we choose, and on which equations we perform the meet-in-the-middle part. So we exhausted all the variants, and in our paper are described the best ones. So here you can see the best attack against 6 rounds of Prince. So the blue nibbles are the ones guessed during the online phase, and the red one are the ones guessed during the offline phase. So as you can see, we exploited the symmetry of Prince to save some key material, and it led to an attack with an overall complexity of 2 to the 34. So at the end of the attack, we only reduce the number of possible values for 33 key bits to 2z5. And it is not enough to perform an exhaustive search to recover the key. So one idea is to apply several meet-in-the-middle attacks. For instance, then we can apply this kind of attack using the knowledge we had from the previous one. And this attack has an overall complexity low enough to not increase the overall complexity of our attack. We apply the same kind of attack against 8 rounds, and after a trade-off, we found an attack with an overall complexity around 2^69, and actually this is the best non-attack against 8 rounds of prints. Against 10 rounds, we did not find attacks requiring less than 2^20 chosen plain text, so we did not submit any attack to the prints challenge. But combined to the differential enumeration technique, which is a powerful and clever trade-off originally found by Dunkelman, Keller, and Shamir, we were able to mount a 10-round attack with a data complexity of 2^57 chosen plain text, a time complexity around 2^68 encryptions, and a memory complexity around 2^41 64-bit block. So this attack has an overall complexity higher than the best non-attack against 10 rounds from Kanto et al. But as you can see, the memory complexity of our attack is much more lower. So it is quite practical. But yet, stealing 2^57 chosen plain text is a very hard task. So against 12 rounds, we didn't find anything. So now let's see a differential set-based attack. So usually, statistical attack require a large quantity of data. So that's not the best bet to when the amount of data is restricted. But as there were challenges against 4 and 6 rounds of prints, it may work, and actually it does. So first, we looked for a high probability differential trail, and here it is the one we used on 6 rounds. So as you can see, the transition in the 3 first rounds are fully specified, except the input of the first sub-nibble, and then it propagates with probability 1. So why this differential trait is interesting? First, because its probability is high enough for us to find pair following it with the requirement of the print challenge of 2^20 chosen plain text, but also because it has a special property. So if we consider a family of 4 pairs such that which is built from 1 pair for which we switch the value of the active nibbles, then if one of those pairs follows the differential, then they all follow it. Okay, so that's a powerful property. And so then the attack is the first step of the attack is classical. The idea is to retrieve the last subkey column by column. First, we take a pair which may follow the differential. We guess the difference in this column, and so we obtain the difference between before and after the first column for the last sub-nibbles, and so we obtain a candidate for the first column of the last subkey. Then we try this candidate against the 3 other pairs of the family, and at the end, we expect, on average, 1 candidate for the family per column. So for the column. So we do the same procedure for the 3 other columns. And at the end, we have 1 candidate per family for the last subkey. So now a classical way to retrieve the master key will be to continue to do a similar procedure one round before. Okay, so we will obtain the three first columns of K1, and we could do things like that. But we tried something different and which is much more fun. We used the SAT solver. So we found that given two families of four pairs, which may follow the differential and which share the same candidate for the last subkey, then if we properly encode the system of equations as a CNF and give it to the SAT solver mini-SAT, then it retrieves the master key in less than a second, taking care of all the nasty details. So we implemented this attack and run it on our personal computer, and it takes about 90 minutes to retrieve the master key. So here, properly encode means first we have to choose a good representation for the S-box, and then we have to simplify the system from all equations like x equal y, something like that. X equal y and x difference of y, because that means x equals to y plus one. Okay, so that's interesting to use the SAT solver here, because when we used a SAT solver without doing anything clever, we were able to break only three rounds. Okay. While here it can be used to break six rounds. Okay. So the attacks I described until now didn't use any special property of prints. So we tried to use the alpha reflections to mount an attack against prints. Blondeau and her co-authors shown that the middle rounds of prints are an involution which has exactly 2 to the 32 fixed bounds. So the middle rounds of, we can study the cycles of the middle rounds of prints, and there are 2 to the 32 cycles of length 1 and 2 to the 63 minus 2 to the 32 cycles of length 2. We studied what happened if we add alpha to these permutations. So these permutations operate on columns, so it was possible to fully study its cycle types. And we found that the cycle types of these permutations are very small. The length of the cycle of these permutations are very small. So as you can see, the probability, if we take an input at random, the probability that he is on the cycle of length smaller than 2 to the 24 is 2 to the minus 4.1, which is quite low for a permutation over 64 bits. So now the question is how to use such information to mount an attack against prints. The only thing we found is we noticed that four rounds of print score plus alpha has the same cycle type than the permutations we studied, because when we iterate four rounds of print score plus alpha, some of the operations are cancelled. So it trivially leads to a distinguisher against four rounds of print score. We first pick a 64-bit word at random. We iterate it over. We iterate it at most 2 to the 15 times, and the experiment is a success if if we found that x is on the, on the cycle of length at most 2 to the 15. So if it is a four round of Prince score, the probability of success is 2 to the minus 12.4, while for a random permutation, it should be 2 to the minus 49. So it leads to a distinguisher requiring 2 to the 27.4 adaptively chosen plain text, and we confirmed it experimentally. So the complexity of this distinguisher was too high to submit it to the Prince challenge, and actually this is not the best attack against four round of Prince score, but we believe it is still interesting because the technique is exotic and may lead to a better attack in the future. So to conclude my talk, in our paper, you will find most of the attacks which won the first round of the Prince challenge. You will find a new attack against 10 rounds of Prince, and a structural analysis of Prince, including the distinguisher I just showed, but also some other stuff we found. Thank you for your attention.